Hey everybody, welcome to the Best Soy Latte and Me. Sorry about that making face thing. But anyway, I am here to do another video for you guys. I am, again, outside in my parents' balcony because it's the best area to film. And I'm just here chilling like a villain. And I apologize for my hair because I have not washed it for 2 days. Sometimes I do that. Like, I don't wash every day and I just put, like, secret stuff on my hair to be able to prevent it. But it's just powder. Whatever. But anyway, in this video, I know if you guys have been following me on Twitter, I've been talking about a couple of things. Like, I had a lot of videos lined up for you, which I mentioned in my video before. And I'm sorry if I really keep touching my hair. I know it's like a Trina habit. Like, some of you call it that, like a Trina habit. Like, when it's a long video or if I touch my hair, it's very Trina. And a lot of you were saying that it's not a video, it's not like my video if I don't touch my hair a lot or if I don't, you know, talk too much. But anyway, I just apologize for my hair because I know that it's like really gross and greasy and whatever. But okay, again, in this video, I'm going to be doing a series, and my voice cracked a little, but I am going to be doing a series, and sorry about that. It's going to be called, what is happening? It's going to be called, I don't know what I'm going to call it. You guys can help me out, but it's going to be mainly e.l.f. stuff. A lot of you have asked me to do my favorite e.l.f. products, and I decided to, you know, hop on it and just get on with it, because a lot of you have already been tweeting me and, like, posting on my profile and, like, messaging me about it. So I am finally granting your wish. For your wish. I don't know if this works, but let's see if this is going to work. Yay! But anyway, this is stupid, but I am granting you your wish, and I'm going to be doing the e.l.f. series. I don't know what to call it because I just don't want to do it. Like, I don't want to call it like e.l.f. series because I think it's a little bit boring, but you guys can help me out, whatever you want to call it, and then post it down below. The best one, I guess, will be the one that I'm going to use. But, yeah, so the introduction to the e.l.f. series is going to be this one. So, like I said, a lot of you have been asking me to do a video on my favorite e.l.f. products. A little bit about e.l.f. e.l.f. stands for iSlipSpace.com. I don't know how long they've been around, but I remember, like, the first time I got an e.l.f. product was Christmas time, maybe 3 or 4 years ago from a friend of mine. And it was, like, the quad, the iQuad thing, and it was in Poison Ivy. It was amazing because it was all green. It was my favorite color. Green's my favorite color. And ever since then, I was like, oh, this is interesting. And then I was starting to get into makeup at that time. And I tried it on and I loved it. And I was like, where do you get these? And she just told me that you can buy them in Watson's. And at the same time, when I went and checked it out, it was so cool because it was only like 129 pesos and like 50 cents or something. Like, round it off, 130. So I did start investing in a lot of e.l.f. products, and if you guys have watched me from the beginning, and I thank you for that, if you'd notice, I did have a lot of e.l.f. hauls, a lot, and I still have a lot of them up to this very moment, and I do update you guys when there are, like, a lot of e.l.f. Products that are out. Like, if you do follow me on Twitter, I know that I've tweeted a lot about, like, their new products in Watson's, and yeah, I do that. I do that a lot. So you guys can follow me on Twitter, and I self-advertise right there. But the link will be down below to my Twitter, and I do reply all the time. But anyway, I am deviating from the topic. So yes, favorite e.l.f. products, and I decided to do it in like a series because I do talk too much, and then I know that I'm going to be like talking about one product so much, especially if I love it. Yeah, so I decided to do, like I said, by series. And what else can I say about e.l.f.? They're really cheap. They do have, like, their normal line, which is, like, they're, in the States, it's called the $1 line. They have their studio line, which is by far my favorite line. Like, the minerals. They also have the mineral line, but I'm not so, I haven't been into the mineral line yet, but the studio has been so far. A lot of my favorites have come from the studio. But anyway, in this video, this is going to be episode one. I guess I can call it episode one of the e.l.f. series. And in the series, I'm going to be doing, like, different looks. So this is the first look that I did, and everything that I used, except for my concealer, totally forgot about the concealer, but everything I used was e.l.f. With this look. And I will link everything down below because I do have a lot of e.l.f. products, like I said. And, yeah, so I decided to do it in series, and I'm just going round and round the bush, and I'm not gonna edit this video, because I never do. But, yeah, okay, so in this, episode, first episode of the e.l.f. series, I don't know what to call it, but, I'll just call it e.l.f. series so far. It's gonna be brushes, since it's gonna be a long intro, like I imagined it would be. So I decided to do brushes in the first episode, just so that, you know, it's not a lot, but it's pretty basic, so it's going to be like brushes, and then I'm probably going to go to eyes, like e.l.f. eyes, and then lips, and then probably break down the face into two more categories, but it's going to be brushes, eyes, lips, face. So tell me what you guys think about that, and yeah, so I'm going to get started right now. So the brushes that I have, I'm going to show you everything that I have anyway, but I'm going to be telling you what my favorite ones. I'm going to run down on everything first, and then just tell me what you guys think. So I do have a couple of the $1 line brushes, and I did have the foundation brush, but I used it so much that it broke, and every time one time that I was cleaning it, it just got out of the handle, and that is a truck, but got out of the handle, and I tried to still use it just for you know, I use the silvery part just to do like random, so I will tell you what I use it for. But then I lost it, so I don't have it right now. But anyway, yes, I do have these three brushes. I have the e.l.f. Professional Bronzing Brush. Can you guys see that? I also have the e.l.f. Professional Blending Eye Brush, which looks like this. And I have the e.l.f. Professional Eyeshadow Brush, which looks like this. Okay, so in the $1 line, this is what I have. And then for the studio brushes, this is what I have. Ew. It's very dirty. All right, so the first one that I immediately bought was the e.l.f. Powder Blush. So it's like a flat top brush. Just looks like this. Very dense. And then I also grabbed for the e.l.f. Blush Brush. So it looks like this. It's tapered in the end and forms like a fan. And then I got the e.l.f. Eyeshadow C Brush. It looks like this. And I got the e.l.f. Contour Blush. e.l.f. Contour Brush. So it looks like this. Alright, so I'm going to run down everything and how I use them. So the first one, my least favorite, would have to be the e.l.f. Professional Bronzing Brush. So it just looks like this. As compared to the studio line, the synthetic brushes, or the bristles of this one is a lot rougher, or more rough. It's not as dense, and as you can see, it doesn't shed a lot, but it sheds a little, and it does attract a lot of dust. So I don't know if you can see that. Can you guys still hear me? I'm not gonna edit that part out, but anyway, so this is how it looks like. It's got like a red tinge to it, but, I use this. I used to use it for like my blush and everything. And then I decided to start using it for a stippling brush. Not so much as a stippling brush, but since it's a blush brush, I decided to use it for my mousse blushes. I have showed you guys in my past favorites. I did say about like the mousse Everblenda mousse blushers, and I used this brush actually just to stipple it on and just to do this. And I do have to warn you guys that it's not as soft. It does hurt a little, but it's not so bad. Like, I just stipple it on just like that, and then the color just gets on there perfectly as I stipple it on. So I just use this as a stippling brush. This one, again, is $129.75 or something like that, so I use it for that one. So that's that. Yeah, so that's my least favorite one. And then, I'm just going to go, like, by the lines. This one is, it's very dirty. Can you see that? This one is the, again, e.l.f. Professional Eyeshadow Brush. And I like the fact that it's pretty big. And what I use this for is for my crease, actually. Just, I dab it on, and then I just lightly pat it on my eyelid, like any flat shader brush that I use. But this one is, I like that the fact that it's a little bit bigger than the Fanny Serrano one. I forgot to bring the Fanny Serrano one with me. It's in my room, but it just looks like this. And how do I explain it? It covers a lot of space, like eyelid space, So I just dab it on and I just do that. I pat it on like I did with this one. And it just works perfectly for that one. I have to say, though, that I do like the e.l.f. Eyeshadow C Brush more just because it's more dense and it packs on more color. I don't know, but I'll compare both. It just looks like this. This one is definitely more dense. This one is more dome-shaped, and this one is a little bit less dense, like I said. Well, a lot less dense than this one. And also, I think this one is so much softer. Like I said, the studio brushes are so much softer than the $1 line. This one, again, costs $129. Like, all of the ones with the white handles are $129.75, if I'm not mistaken. And, yeah, and they're very easy. This one doesn't have a lot of fallout. I've been using this for the longest time, probably for, like, two years, probably, before I got the professional eyeshadow C brush, or before, as well, like, I alternate this one and the Fanny Serrano brush. And, yeah, so that's that. And then, by far, one of my favorites from the e.l.f. Brushes, it doesn't matter if it's studio or $1, would have to be this one. It's the e.l.f. Professional Blending Eye Brush. I cannot say enough good things about this brush. There is a tricycle. And, oh, it's a motorcycle. But I did say that I chose mine very carefully, because a lot of the others are just, like, not as dome-shaped or not as tall as the brush of this one. So I did carefully weed it out one by one. So I just kept looking and looking and looking until I found, like, the perfect one. And this one has got to be my favorite blending brush ever. So this is, again, the e.l.f. Professional Blending Brush. And it's just so easy to just blend just for your outer V, just like that. And it's very big and it's very fluffy, so it just blends really easily. I just cannot say enough about this one. So if I suggest that you guys buy a e.l.f. brush, if you want to ask me what e.l.f. brush you're going to buy, I suggest that you buy this one as your blending brush. I love this. Absolutely love it. All right, and then let's go over to the studio line. Yeah, so what happened to my voice? All right, so let's talk about the eye brushes. All right, so since I already mentioned this one, the eyeshadow C brush, this one, like I said, packs on a lot of color. It's very dense. I like the fact that it's very dense, just because I think that I feel like it drips more. It drips. Is that the correct term? Like the color or the eyeshadow just holds on to the brushes more, and then when I pack it on, it just falls right onto my eyelid. What am I saying? But anyway, yes, I do like this brush a lot just because it's very dense. I like the look of this brush as well. It's very sleek, very professional. This one is like a smooth handle. It's sort of like the NARS packaging as well. But I do like the C brush a lot. It just has the same purpose as this one, except the fact that this one is more dense, and it's so much easier to clean, actually. But it dries a lot slower because it does have a lot more brushes on it, or like bristles on it. So that's that. And then I also do love the e.l.f. contour brush. It just looks like this. And I will compare it to the e.l.f. What do you call this again? Blending eye brush. It just looks like this. It's so much smaller. It's more of a less tapered shape. As you can see, it's a little bit smaller as well. But this one, again, is like the other brushes from the studio line. It's more dense as compared to this one. This one, what I use this for is, I don't know if I've used this in probably a couple of my, well, probably two of my tutorials. And what I use this for is I do have the motion of, like, lining my crease line or my lid. So I use this one since it's very small. It's perfect for just lining that one right over here, and then since it is small, it doesn't go like beyond the line that I need it to be in, so I just do it like that, and it does blend in perfectly. And as for my outer V, I use this as well just to do it like right on the outer V, and then carefully I just blend it upwards. It's just perfect because it's a perfect size for that. And as for this one, I use this more for like blending and then outer, kind of like when I want to smudge it outer a bit, so I still use that as well. So these two, probably like blending brushes, are by far my favorite brushes because they do wonders with your makeup. So I do like these two a lot. All right, and then for the e.l.f. blush brush, I do like this. It's not super like one of my, it's not like my super favorite. I still like the Marionade angle blush brush more. But this one is, again, softer. It has a tapered out, shape. And I guess they decided to do it that way just because when you want to do your bronzer and you want to do, like, the contouring or whatever, like when you do your fish face, which I do, you can use, like, the end, the tapered end, just to go. Because it's very precise like that. And what I do with this brush is, for example, my phone is my bronzer or my blush. What I do is I use the flat side, just like that, and I gently just dab it on. And then what I use this side for is for highlighting. So I use my e.l.f. highlighter or whatever highlighter I use, and I just dab it on, just like on my cheekbones, just like that. And I also use this just for down the bridge of my nose, my Cupid's bow down here, and a little bit up here onto my brow bones. So I do like this brush just for the purpose of that. Yep, but then if it's for like blushing per se, I do like my Marionade brush better just because it's angled and it's soft and it's dense. But this brush also has a lot of usage. I do use this for multiple purposes as well. Yeah, and then the last one that I actually have is the e.l.f. powder brush. I cannot say enough good things about this brush. It's just a flat top brush. It's very dense. I have tried this as a powder brush, and I have tried this as a liquid foundation brush, but I do use this for my liquid foundations. And what I would do is I pump, because it's usually a pump, I pump my foundation onto the back of my hand, and I do this. What I do is I stipple it on, just stipple it all over, and then I blend it just a little bit, and then I stipple it, pack it on again, just so that the color stays into my skin, or like seeps into my skin more. I know it sounds gross, like you don't want makeup to be like seeping into your skin, but just so that it grips onto your skin more. So that's what I do. I just stipple it on, blend, and then stipple again. And I do like the fact that it is very malleable. It's dense, but it is very malleable, and it does get into like all the crevices of your face. So it's very helpful like that, except for my nose. Like, I do have to like pat it on a little bit, especially down here, because sometimes you miss the areas around here. But I still love this brush. I cannot say enough good things about this brush. And as for a powder brush, it also works miracles because it does like the buffering effect. I love buffering in my powder, which is also why I love my Revlon Kabuki brush. But since I don't have a Kabuki brush from e.l.f. yet, I just use the Revlon one, which works wonders for me. But like I said, for the liquid foundation, this is what I use. So I just, again, this is what I do, buffer it on. And that's it. And then lastly, for my foundation brush, which I don't have, it comes in a yellow bristle brush. It's very thin, it's not dense, it's very malleable. I probably used it for over like maybe a year and a half, or probably even 2 years, before it actually broke off the handle, and it just like slid off, like the glue couldn't hold it anymore, I guess. And I still use that. In the beginning, I used it as a foundation brush, but then I got a couple other foundation brushes which I preferred more than that one. But I love that brush. I love using that brush as a moisturizer brush. So what I would do is usually just dip it into, like, get my Garnier, and then I use that one just to, like, put my moisturizer on. And then after I do that, I just use my fingers just to buff it out. Or sometimes I do use it as a brush for my St. Ives, like, pack, the face pack, the green one that I showed you before. I use the brush just so that it doesn't get into my fingers, and I like the precision of that brush as a, like, you know, brush for that mask. And I like it because it doesn't get to your fingers as much, and, you know, it gives a precise application. I like that it's just perfect for, like, mask application, so I do like that. I think I will repurchase it just for that one, just because I don't want to get my hands sticky. But, yeah, so the ones that I would really highly suggest to you guys, I really highly suggest you guys would buy would be, of course, the e.l.f. powder brush. This one is $249.75. It's a little bit more expensive because it is the studio line, but I'm telling you guys it's worth it. So this one, again, is the e.l.f. powder brush. I also suggest that you get these two blending brushes. And that is a dog. And I find it so funny that I have to tell you guys what it was, and like, duh, Trina, we know that that's a dog. But anyway, so I do suggest that you also get these two blending brushes. Again, the e.l.f. contour brush and the e.l.f. blending eye brush. And then I like these two as well, but if you just want to get one, I suggest you use the C-brush. But this is, because this is more dense, practically the same, but this is more dense. But if you want one just for a spare one, and it's pretty cheap, so go ahead and get this one. If you just want like a spare one while you wash the others, this is a good buy as well. And then, yes, I will suggest that you buy the e.l.f. blush brush as well, just for like if you're into highlighting like I am. It's just a perfect brush for highlighting, stuff like that. And I do like that that I can use like the flat side of the brush, just so not a lot of the product, especially a lot of my pigmented blushes. Sorry about that. A lot of my pigmented blushes are, you know, I don't want too much on my face. Can you guys still hear me? So I just tap it off and just use the flat side of the brush, and it gives me the perfect, perfect cheek color. So, man, why are you noisy? That is my neighbor's dog, which evidently is my dog's son or daughter or whatever, but that's my dog's kid. So, shh. All right. And then this one, not so much. If you, I'd suggest that you buy another, blush brush. If you were me, I do suggest the Marionade blush instead. Blush instead of getting this one. But yeah, I don't really have anything to use this for, except for since I have it, I just suggested I used it for something. But yeah, that's it. And then for the foundation brush, if you're lazy like me, if you want to do the Studio Line foundation brush, sorry about my hair, very windy here, get it if you want to use it just for like putting on your mask or whatever, because you're lazy like me. But that's it. I hope you guys like the series so far. I will be trying out a lot of these studio brushes. I still have a couple more that I haven't gotten, but I just decided to get these ones first because I know I'm gonna get a lot of use out of these ones for the most part. So again, that is it. This is the first episode of the blank, whatever you guys suggest to call it, and I will, you know, pick out from all of your suggestions. And yes, and also I wanna tell you guys that I might be getting a P.O. box soon. So just if you guys wanna just randomly send me notes, or I love receiving notes, I love receiving letters or whatever. If you guys, I do reply to letters because I like writing a lot. But yeah, if you guys want to send me notes or send me whatever you want to send me, I will be opening a P.O. box soon so I can interact with you guys more, which I think is going to be awesome. I'm really excited for that. Yeah, so that's it. Tell me what you guys think about that as well. And everything, all the info will be on the down bar. Everything that I'm wearing on my face will be on the down bar. And I'm just going to run through really fast, but I will also put it in the down bar. My ring is from Forever 21. I showed this in a recent haul. My necklace is just an Assumption pendant that my mom gave me, and this one is from Hong Kong. It's like a spinning rabbit. My earrings are from Green Hills, which I got like a long time ago because I love pearl earrings. It's like my everyday thing. And man, I cannot catch a break. But yeah. And then my cardigan is from Cotton On. My top is from SM Surplus, I think. And you can't see my shorts, so I will not tell you anyway. But yeah, that's it. And on my fingers is Sweet Almond. I will be showing that in a recent haul video, part two of my birthday haul video. So I got, this is Sweet Almond. And on my finger, I know it's a little bit chipped. This one is Caress Disco Fever, I think. They're both from Caress. So that's it. And a ponytail, because it's hot. And my dog, oh well, that's not my dog, but the dog doesn't want to shut up. But that's it. Again, all the contact details will be on the down bar. Again, wait for the next episode. Ooh, it's gonna be for the eyes. All right, so that's it. I hope you guys like this video, and I will see you guys really soon. Oh, check this out. I'll do it one more time. I'll see you guys really soon. Bye. Mwah. Cool. Bye.